This is my new Keurig K55 Classic Series single serve coffee maker. Let's take it out of the box, see what we got, and check it out. Instruction booklet. Accessory package. And the brewer itself.
It's shipped adequately protected with this strapping tape. Let's get this off. This certainly wasn't going to come apart before it was supposed to. Okay. So let's look at our control panel. We have power button on off. We have an auto off button, which turns off the auto off feature, which will shut the brewer down 2 hours after the last cup has been brewed. We have the heating light, which indicates the water is being warmed up. We have a descale indicator, which tells you that it's time to descale the unit. There's a procedure for that in the instruction book. Particularly useful if you have heavy mineral content in your water, and an add water light for the reservoir. Down below we have our brew size selection, basically for 5 1/4, 7 1/4, or 9 1/4 ounce brew sizes. Here on top we have the latch for the K-cup holder. This is removable. Just grasp it on the sides and it snaps out. It's going to be cleaned. Just align the mark and then pops right in. Put your K-cup, close the lid, press your brew size, start brewing. Off to the left here, we have the water reservoir, which simply lifts up and off. This particular reservoir holds 48 ounces of water. And in the accessories was this water filter, which comes with these filter cartridges, which are inserted in here and then placed inside with a firm snap. For water purification. Let's put the lid back on the reservoir and place it back on. The unit snaps right into place. Down below we have our cup holder, which catches excess water. The top can be removed for cleaning. All in all, a very nice unit. So the next thing we need to do is a brewer rinse, as Keurig calls it. We're going to take the water filter insert that goes into the reservoir tank and squeeze these buttons on either side. Pull it apart and take one of our apparently charcoal carbon water filters and insert it inside like that. Snap the bottom back on like that and insert it into the reservoir as outlined earlier. Next, we'll fill the reservoir up with filtered or bottled water as per the instructions. Replace the top and place it back onto the brewer. We place a mug, large mug, on the Brewer drip tray. We press the power button on the panel. At this point, the Brewer will automatically fill with water. It takes about 4 minutes. The heating red light should illuminate during this time. Once the water is heated, the red heating light should turn off. When the three blue lights illuminate, it indicates that the Brewer is ready to brew the coffee. To start, we lift and lower the handle. We would normally put in the pod, but since this is a rinse, we won't do that. We'll close it. The blue lights are flashing. We press the small mug button, and we'll get started. And here it comes. So there it is, our first cup of hot water in this case. I'm looking forward to using my new Keurig brewer. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.